right? People think that these spirits and demons are their loved ones. They're not. They're demons, okay? They're like, oh, it's my grandma. Yeah, she's just floating around in the room, etc. And she just decided to sit down on the sofa and speak with you. I mean, this stuff isn't biblical. It's not biblical that you could speak to your dead grandma, okay? But what is biblical is, they, you know, God warning and forbidding us from summoning spirits, from using mediums, et cetera, right? And this is no different than turning to mediums, right? In Leviticus chapter 19, verse 31, do not turn to mediums or seek out spiritists, for you will be defiled by them. I am the Lord your God. And this is what people are starting to do because, of course, remember, what at the same time here is we're weakening humans more and more and more. Right? People are becoming more and more childish, so they can't, as adults, accept the death of somebody else. Even if their mother is 90 years old and dies, they can't handle it. They can't deal with it. They're regressing, not just spiritual regression, but literally regressing in age. Man, we have adults who are behaving like kids. So back to this story, because this is how they're going to continue to get people on board with this type of tech, and they don't even know what they're doing. So this Missouri man moved the internet to tears with a video clip. So I said, I decided to do something special for my mom this year for Christmas. Philip, who is 27, explained in the caption of the video, which has amassed over 5.6 million views on the platform. The St. Louis native who creates content for The Content Guy explained in the caption that his father, John, passed away in 2022 after a battle with pancreatic cancer. He wanted to do something unique to honor his hero, so he decided to digitally resurrect him with AI, specifically with the technology he frequently uses for work, okay? Does anyone not see where this is going? Like, this is going to become a new normal thing. Digital resurrections with AI, uploading your consciousness. People just don't seem to court. They're like, well, it's just a computer software program, right? Because they use this terminology to make people think that it's something, you know, that they can't really comprehend. So they're like, oh, yeah, you know, I'm not a tech wizard, so I guess that they don't think of it in terms of spiritual. And the spiritual realm and mediums and things that God forbids us to do, like the verse I just read from Leviticus, right? It will defile you. You'll be defiled by them, right? And it's defiled by these spirits as well. That there's somebody thinking that it's their dead grandma, or in this case, this woman's dead husband and this guy's dead father, right? Because everybody who hears this story, like, that's really cool. That's really neat. That's what the response is. People out there are like, that's wonderful. That's great. I'm going to try it. Christians as well are obviously going to be easily deceived by this because they're not saying it's a spirit or a demon that's being evoked here. They're going to go, oh, you know, it's just AI. It's just some software program like GarageBand or something like that on an Apple. And everyone's going to go, oh, yeah, what's this guy talking about? If they flat out told you what they're really doing and what AI really is and, you know, why quantum computers have to be held kept so cold. And then, of course, everything we know about what they're trying to do with bringing things over from the other side with certain or just basic stuff that we know as Christians that the Bible tells us about witchcraft and witches and about allowing them to live as well. Right? What do you think witches are doing in their rituals and the things that they do? You don't think they're invoking spirits? Of course they are. Right? This is just a new way to do it and to convince you that it's not that, it's something else, and then everybody falls for it. Right? Instead of being like, you know what, my grandma died. I don't really need to bring her back as AI. You know, as a Christian, you go, well, you know, I'll see her in the new heaven. Oh, you know, my grandma was saved. I'm saved. Great. See you then. I don't need to bring grandma over on a digital Christmas card and be a psychopath. But, you know, weaker society, everyone's just love, love, love is really a new word for weak, 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 because they just tie a ribbon of love around everything and everybody accepts it and tolerates it. Right? Oh, let them do what thou wilt is the mindset. So the Missourian specifically used 11 Labs tech to speech software to match his deceased dad's exact voice, something he found paramount to making the project a reality. And here's the other thing we have to listen about here with the, you know, how they kind of just put this stuff out there and you're supposed to accept it, right? The same with deepfakes, that this technology is allowed to exist. So they instead of you fighting back against going, wait, what? There's software that could capture my voice. And then, you know, all these people are watching, like, true crime shows, etc., and they're like, oh, the guy made a phone call. That's enough, you know, to arrest him for the murder, etc. He said this on the phone. Oh, well, now we know that they could obviously fake all this stuff, and we've all known this for a while, right? So now they need to convince you why this technology is good instead of going, whoa, bad people in high places could use this type of tech to manipulate and frame people, etc. And everyone's like, they wouldn't do that. They won't do that, right? My name's probably right at the top of the list of people they're looking to frame. Clearly, right? And everybody don't believe it. They're like, he's a crazy nut on YouTube, a conspiracy theorist, blah, blah, blah. Look, it's his voice, right? You all you got to do. I mean, this guy's got all he did was capture his dad's voice for probably a voicemail or something like that. And then he puts it into 11 labs, and then they could recreate a speech, right? This is dangerous technology that should be illegal. Illegal, but we continue to allow it, right? Deepfakes should be illegal. How are we? They're like, oh, it, you know, it serves benefits. Oh, yeah, what's the benefit? Making you laugh when somebody deepfakes Tom Cruise, right? Isn't, you know, you'll hear these celebrities going, hey, it's a violation of my privacy, etc. Everybody's on board with it, of course, because they know what this eventually means for them being able to rid the world of people like us, right? Because they could easily manipulate these people, and they continue to do that, so they could do and get away with whatever they want. And then they normalize the technology by saying, don't be alarmed by the fact that this guy could do it. You should be amazed and say it's so sweet and lovely and that you want to do it too. Yeah. So they say, using this tech, the content creator managed to create a digital dead ringer for his dad's tone and cadence. The actual first words that I put in the program was, hi, honey. And he said, and I can't tell you how many times I've heard my late father say that in my life, which was why I had it as the first thing I put in. When the program said it in his voice, I got chills all over my body. Then that's when I was like, I'm doing this no matter what. All right? Okay, so then he said, I mean, there's like little things that they're using too. He said, you know, I hear your prayers, right? Using little minute. So they're doing deceitful things, right? This is AI. I hear your prayers. They're trying to make it seem like, oh, and God is bringing back this person's dead person spiritually. And I mean, people are just going to continue to go along this road. They are. They're going to be deceived by this. They don't know what they're doing. I mean, it's pretty easy to say we can look around and say that most people don't know what they're doing. So he then used his dad's voice to create a digital Christmas card, thereby simulating having his father home for the holidays. And a touching clip, not frightening, touching, right? There's your manipulation. His mother is seen opening the video book, which you saw, which features a montage of photos of the pair. Then all of a sudden, her late husband greets her. Hi, honey, I love you. I hear your prayers. I want you to know that you're the best mother to our kids. You know, and he said, and you're the strongest woman in the whole world. I'm always with you, honey, and I hope you guys have a Merry Christmas. The clip concludes with the mother and son embracing over the heart-rending remembrance. It's been so long since we've heard his voice. Then it was amazing. I can also tell you certainly that this is going to make it easier for her to get through this holiday because she's been reminded of him. And now she knows he's with her always. Now, I don't know how, what kind of a psychopath you have to be to hear somebody's voice that's not even really that, you know what I mean? Like, to hear a card of somebody's dead who's like, hey, Merry Christmas, I'm dead. You know, that's going to make you feel better. Doesn't that make you worse, you would think, psychologically? You know, but of course, to these people, I mean, sure, let's just accept all this stuff, allow all this stuff. Nobody, and then when I talk about this stuff and I say, hey, they could do this, they could do that, everyone's like, oh, that's crazy. You're, you know, they don't care about you, they don't care about so-and-so, they're not going to frame anyone. Who are these evil people, right? Well, exactly. Who are the people who are creating this tech, who hide behind a curtain, right? And they're allowed to do it, and they're allowed to just shove it into the world, and then nobody's regulating it, right? And everybody can do it to one another. It's an utter insanity. So this will continue to be normalized. And, of course, the feedback, some people are like, oh, that's creepy, right? You're thinking, oh, that's creepy, it's a little weird. Or the majority of people accepting it and loving it, thinking it's the best thing that's ever happened to the world, and they can't wait to do it with their cousin or their sister or their ex-boyfriend or their ex-wife, et cetera, et cetera. Instead of facing it, dealing with it, again, we could just turn like children and then hope that the digital world can recreate our dead loved ones, and we won't connect that to the Bible talking about contacting mediums or spirits because it's AI. That's not the same thing because they just name it something else, right? Kind of like Aleister Crowley, you know, they used to have demons and now they call them aliens, right? But nobody sees the deception here. So this type of technology should be outlawed. It should be banned. We shouldn't allow it in our society to exist, right? But we do. We do because you have to, if you play on people's heartstrings like they do, then everybody accepts it. The same thing they're doing with transhumanism. I said it for years. They're going to continue to use your health benefits with connecting humans to machines. Oh, the brain chip. Oh, you know, they love to use war veterans and say, oh, well, they got a new leg. They got a new arm. And everyone goes, that's wonderful. Thank God for the modern advancements in technology, et cetera, et cetera. They desensitize you, get you to accept this type of stuff, which should be forbidden, mixing of iron and clay. It's happening right before our eyes. And even things like this, where, you know, oh, it's so wonderful, isn't it? No, it's not really wonderful. Do you really know what you're talking to there? Are they like, oh, it's just a video game? I mean, what are they thinking that's actually happening here when they're recreating their dad's voice? They're not thinking anything, right? They're like, well, I taped it in and tell it what to say, and it's AI, and that doesn't mean that it's anything to do with spirits or evoking spirits through artificial dumb. Not at all. Just continue living in lollipop land. I thank everybody for being here. Hope you're all doing well. God bless you as always and your families.